Hello everyone, my name is SiC, and welcome back to our playthrough of Civilization 5, where we are playing as the Soshone people. We are slowly working our way towards a cultural victory. We are in the mid to late game now. We're at turn 299, and usually these games, they take about 500 turns, give or take. So we're well on our way, and I'm doing quite well on the cultural front, actually. We have a lot of archaeologists out in the field digging up antiquity sites like this one over here. We still have one in my territory over there that I can dig up. We've already sent one archaeologist over towards the antiquity sites to our northeast as well. And yeah, overall, we're looking quite healthy there. There's another one over here, actually, an antiquity site that I might want to pick up in the near future. And in about two turns, I think I will get started on the production of the Eiffel Tower in Mozankani, because we just unlocked that with the radio technology. We are now in the modern age. So, yeah, overall, everything is going quite well. I've done all I can do in this turn, so let's go to the next one. And let's continue on our way to the future. He wants incense or 5 gold per turn. Yeah, okay. That's fine. I need all the money that I can get. So, let's see, we were making a bank in Tomawak, a garden in Agadika. Beshbalik is just going about on its own way, as it's our puppet city. I'm not really looking to Beshbalik to do anything specific. Hanoi and Venice are now allies, okay. Genghis Khan has negotiated peace with the city-states. So it looks like Spain and Egypt are very happy, and I'm third in the third place. Montezuma is still very happy for someone who only has one city, and probably almost next to no luxury resources. That's very strange. Right, we finished our archaeologist in Goshut, so let's send him over towards this antiquity site over there. And let's build another one, because there is another one to the west over here. Right, so Genghis Khan has, we had a trade agreement with Mongolia and Indonesia, so let's see what we can do with them. He has silk, which I would like to have. Maybe he will give me wine in exchange for wine. He's happy with that, so that's good. And then we have Mongolia. What do you have for trades? Nothing really. So what will we okay, he doesn't have anything left to give me for my luxury resources. Enrico Dandolo, what about you? Ivory for cotton. Yep, sweet. Montezuma, I don't think he has anything to trade. Nope. Minus 14 gold per turn. He's going to be bankrupt really soon. There's nothing he can do about it for now. But we are ready to adopt another policy. So I could go down the rationalism tree, but since we have already unlocked an ideology as well, I might as well go deeper into this and see what we can do on a second level here. Right, we could go for a volunteer army, but I'm not going to war, so that's fine. I don't really need it. Specialists and cities produce half the normal amount of unhappiness, and golden ages last 50% longer. This would be very powerful, because we are already in a golden age, which should make it last for a little bit longer. And it should make people even happier. So, let's see, we could also have landmarks and great person improvements produce plus 4 of the appropriate yield. This would be very powerful for our science, because we have about 3 academies. They all produce plus 10 science. And that will be, this will give us another 8, plus 8 science on top of the 313 that we are already producing. But I think universal suffrage for now is like the best choice. We have extra happiness because our specialists in our cities are producing less unhappiness now. Sadly, our golden age remains the same. I had thought that maybe this would jump up to 10 or something like that, but apparently not. The Mongolian spies stole the secrets of navigation. Well, yeah, okay. I wasn't really doing anything with that, so whatever, bro. Genghis Khan has made peace with a lot of city-states, because he has made peace with Ramses as well. Okay. Doesn't look like Spain or Egypt got a whole lot done against Mongolia. I think they wanted to attack Warsaw, but Mongolia has a pretty strong army as well. So there's not a whole lot that they can do. Right, we have another antiquity site over here. We should get another person coming over here. Alright, do I want to just give him truffles? No, because he's not asking for that in this way. Let's say 5 gold per turn. Yeah, that's better. I'm not going to give it to you for free. Like, this was not the pop-up that asks for charity, where it will lead to a positive reputation. So there's no real reason for me to accept that, you know? Because it's not going to give me anything. It doesn't give me reputation, it doesn't give me money, it just makes me lose one of my luxury resources. I mean, I have some of it to spare, but somebody else could purchase it for me for a price. So, what the hell. Goshute has converted to another religion. Ah, okay. Yeah, that was bound to happen at some point. Alright. That does not surprise me in the least, but I wonder, what does that religion do? Let's see, world religion, Buddhism, right? Beliefs. +2 gold for each city following this religion. Oh, that's only for Spain. Let's see, +20 strength, combat strength in enemy cities that follow the same religion, I guess. Okay. And then we have the ability to purchase pagodas. So that could be interesting, because this will give us +2 faith and +2 culture, plus something else, I think. Gardens provide +2 happiness in city. I'm not sure if we have a garden in Goshute, but maybe we do. And +2 faith from quarries, that is useless to us. Use faith to purchase any type of great person. Yeah, that could be. Yeah, I already have that actually, so it doesn't really do anything for us either. But let's see, purchase. We have enough faith now to build or to purchase a great person. We could go for a great writer. A pagoda for +2 happiness, +2 culture, and +2 faith. That could be very nice, actually. But do I want to spend 600 gold on that? Or because I could get a great writer and then boost our tourism. And I think tourism is the bigger priority for me right now. So yeah, let's go for a great writer instead. Let's see, production in Mozankani is finished. All right, that's good. Let's get the Eiffel Tower. This will give us +12 tourism, +5 happiness and 1 culture, plus and great merchant points as well. So, and alternatively, there is Broadway, which will give us 1 free great musician and contains 3 slots for great works of music. But the Eiffel Tower is much stronger for what we want to do in this game. So, let's see. The archaeologist has arrived, so let's start digging. In 3 turns, we will have another archaeologist in Goshute, which we will send to the west. Yep, open borders with him, that's fine. That is really nice. She wants incense for 4 gold per turn. Let's see if we can make that 5, because I don't really like Spain anymore. Let's make them pay. Mary Shelley, that is really nice. That will give us Frankenstein, probably. I don't know, Mary Shelley wrote more books, I think. But Frankenstein is obviously the most famous one. And there's a quote in there that I really like. That it's something like, for the sympathy of one person, I would make peace of all the world. There is love in my heart, like which you cannot imagine, and rage, like you would not believe. And if I cannot have one, then I will indulge in the other. Something like that is the quote. And that's like me to a T. That is exactly who I am, almost. So that's really cool. Let's see. I'm not sure if that's actually the quote that we get from Mary Shelley's book here. I don't think so, but let's see. That is not a quote that I like, actually, because, like I said before, I'm a backpacker, I'm a traveler. The idea of staying in my village all my life, that's just damn depressing. I really don't like that. But oh well. Goshute has converted to another religion. Yeah, we already had that message last turn. Why is it popping up again? That's weird. Oh well, Agadika has finished. They could make Broadway, but it would take 30 turns, and that's not really all that great. But the broadcast tower could be powerful, because it will give us plus 33 culture in this city. But instead, let's go for... another archaeologist would be nice. Because we have another antiquity site down there that I would like to have. Right, and we're not making any more archaeologists for now. Because Mozankani is now focused on building the Eiffel Tower. So, Hanoi wants somebody bullied. Same for Valletta. We're almost no longer the ally of Valletta, but that's... Yeah, I'm not going to concern myself with that too much for now. Maybe in 16 turns I will try to buy the friendship of some of these city-states. Because I would like to be the world leader, because that gives you more delegates as well. I'm not the world leader, but like the host. World leader is actually the victory condition for the diplomatic victory. Got a new unit from Valletta though. Looks like another Janissary. Yep, okay. Let's get a boost for open terrain and move them to Agadika, because there's no military unit in that city for now. And there's a lot of open area around it, so... Yeah, Tomoak has finished. We could go for another archaeologist, but that's not. Hydro plants could be very powerful now, because this will give us plus one production in every tile next to a river. And we have quite a few rivers, but yeah, let's see, it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or yeah, so all the way up to here, like all of these tiles would get plus one production. Let's do it. Let's go for the hydro plants. And then later on I want one in Agadika and I want one in Mozankani as well. Actually, how much is it to purchase one of those? 1,050. I'm okay with that, actually. If I purchase this, let's see, because we have 74 production right now. 86. Look at that. That's really nice. And now, instead of 14 turns, we have 11 turns until the Eiffel Tower is built. So that's really powerful. That's really nice. Right, Montezuma doesn't like us for our proposal. I don't really care. Look at this, all of our academies surrounding Mozankani. Another one down towards Totomowak, which gives us plus 10 science and plus 1 food and plus 1 production. Same for these other ones, actually. This one actually gives us plus 2 production, same as that one. That's nice. Right, these guys have finished. Let's move them towards the river and build another farm. These guys have finished as well, so let's move them onto the hill and build a mine. Archaeologist is finished. Let's send him over towards the west and have another production ready to go. So we have quite a lot of river here as well, so let's go for another hydro plant. That will really help us out in the future. So Malacca wants us to find more natural wonders. Yerevan has a public work. And yeah, that's still... Looks like one of our archaeologists has finished. Our Janissary can fortify. Let's see, we could have a Polish artifact. And a landmark improvement really does not do anything for us in this position. So let's go for the Polish artifact. Gives us even more tourism output. Can I upgrade the Soshone Knights into anything, I wonder? He wants to attack Montezuma again. You are really a warmonger this turn, but I have no interest. I don't want this. Let's see, we could go for another archaeologist for this antiquity site over there. You could even steal them out of other people's territory, but that will upset them quite a bit. And I don't really want to do that, so I'm just going to stick to the neutral territory and whatever is within my own territories. Though my own territories have been picked clean already. This one goes to Barcelona. Yep, that seems fine. Plus 10 gold income, that's good. I didn't know that this one got pillaged actually, so let's repair it. I noticed that in the last turn when I sent them over the other direction, but... let's see... How are we doing on production? You could use production actually, so let's because it's suggesting a trading post, but let's go for production instead. Let's see, let's build a lumber mill inside of the woods over there. And let's go to the next turn. Ah, another archaeologist has finished. In go shoot, a Spanish artifact. Cool. And that helps with our culture and our tourism. So let's see, how are we doing? 69 turns until we are influential over Indonesia. 72 turns for Mongolia. 17 for the Aztecs. 323 for Venice. But we only met them a while ago, so this we have something... We have to keep up with them a little bit. Or we have some... You know, we have to... make up for some time, basically. We're still going pretty slowly with Egypt, because they have a lot of... Not a lot of tourism output, but they have some. Right, and Spain as well. Well, we're doing really well with converting all the other ones to towards our culture. So, let's see, let's build our lumber mill there. Tomoak has finished, let's build an archaeologist, because I did see this antiquity site there, which I want. Go shoot. Could build, let's see, is there another antiquity site anywhere near us? Doesn't look like it's only the one up there. Oh no, there's one up here as well. So we could steal that one by building an archaeologist here as well. Let's see, we have a lot of spy reports. In Madrid, uncovered that Isabella is secretly plotting against Montezuma. Yep, I'll warn him. He's neutral with us, but that's fine. And what else? Ramses is constructing the Red Fort, okay. Ramesses is secretly plotting against Montezuma. Let's share that as well. Let's prepare him as best as we can. It's probably not going to do much, but oh well. I mean, it doesn't look like he has much of an army, right? There's nothing in these styles, so there should be an army in his city and around it. But what's that going to do against Spain and Egypt? It doesn't really do anything. If they want, they can take them out of the game right away. It's no problem. Alright, let's see what's going on over... Yeah, they're doing quite well on the army still. Mongolia, I mean. Right, that's finished. Let's go for a farm. Our golden age has ended, which is sad. And our happiness is going down as well. Down to 22. It's not a whole lot. But there's nothing else we can do in this turn, I don't think. Ah, right. Get started on the archaeological dig. Let's see, we cannot upgrade our knight quite yet. Our janissaries neither. These guys cannot be upgraded, because this is something I want to keep in mind. Nobody can be upgraded. Okay. That's cool. That's fine. We are still ahead of everyone else, I think. I mean, Mongolia has a trebuchet and pikemen. I can shoot them from a distance. So, yeah. I'm looking okay there. He wants to give us 150 gold and iron for 30 turns for cotton. That's fine, actually. That's a lot of gold. More than I would get in 50 turns. If he only gives me like, or 30 turns for 5 gold per turn or something. Or, it's actually about the same. Yeah, 150. Man, my math inside of my head, like the calculations inside of my head is really, really bad. Especially because I'm trying to think about all the other stuff going on inside of this game as well, so... You've got to excuse me for that one. Let's go towards this antiquity site and start production on, let's see, we need more happiness, so we could go for a zoo. Yeah, let's go for a zoo. Our declaration with Indonesia has run its course, let's renew it. They disliked our proposal to the World Congress, but they really liked everything else we've done. So, yeah. Let's keep our good relations with them going. Another archaeological dig has finished. I forgot all about this one. An Egyptian artifact. Yep, for sure. I want that. Let's see. I have 39. Like, I'm really going ahead of everyone else there. I'm slowly reaching the conclusion that Prince difficulty might actually be a little bit too easy for me. Maybe. I mean, I could still lose in the diplomacy game because we're equal with Egypt, but everything else, like, we're doing pretty well. And I mean, they could bum rush me and take my cities from me as well. We have discovered biology. Right. Egyptian army is currently marching towards Lodz. Let's share the intrigue as well. Just because we can. And we have oil. Let's see. Over here. That's quite far away, and that's good. Another one. Down there. Alright, cool. And, there's two towards Goshute. So that's really good. And then finally, we have Valletta requesting our assistance against invading barbarians. That's not going to happen. Sorry about that, but nope. Lodz is going to be taken pretty soon, and then the Aztecs are out of the game. For sure. But before they can... Yeah, it doesn't matter if they actually expand their cultural influence over the Antiquity Site, because if they hate me for taking it away from them, they're going to be eliminated pretty soon anyway. So I can do what I want. Alright, archaeologist, let's send him over. That's three turns to get there. That's fine. These guys can start digging. Let's choose a production over here. We have enough. Let's go for... We could go for a garden or happiness. Let's go for a zoo instead, I think. Or, you know what? No, let's go for gardens. Because, like, as much... I could use as many great people as I could possibly get. Right, and we're doing quite well on the Eiffel Tower as well. I'm way ahead of in science, so I have a really good time advantage to building all of these wonders. This looks like a really good deal. So let's go for that. Let's see, how are we doing, like, on bonuses? 80% bonus to Egypt, yep. 40 to Indonesia. 120 for Mongolia for all of these things. So we have the open borders, trade routes, and a shared religion. Only takes 50 more turns to become influential over them. Oh, nice, you got another great writer. That's really cool. And then 80% for Spain, because we don't share a religion. 40% for the Aztecs, because we have open borders, but they're going to be eliminated. Hope, maybe we could still get the influential. Doesn't really matter anymore if they get killed, but it would be nice regardless if we can have it. Velmiki, I've never heard of this guy. I wonder what he wrote. Interesting. Somebody who refers to himself in the third person. You know, that's never a really good thing, so how could that be a great work, you know? People who refer to themselves in the third person are the most annoying people in the world. So, I don't see how that could ever be considered a work of art. Alright, Spanish artifacts, another one. Right, I think I have two now. Two Spanish artifacts, let's see. Our culture. Felmiki the Great Writer, oh yeah, so that's the library. Hermitage, it's all art. Sistine Chapel is also for arts. Amphitheater, so we have Frankenstein, that's it's books as well. Let's see. How can we see? This is all music. Interesting. Moson Kani produces a lot of culture, eh? But one of these should say, oh yeah, beads from Spain, beads from Egypt, beads from the Soshone, a mask from the Soshone. Right, okay, so that's how it looks. These are just like little bags or something, or like... This is a pot of ink, but it works for the other stuff as well. No, it's actually great art. Right, okay, so it has the image of great art. Something to remember. My bad. Hopefully our influence will soon spread over towards the mountain over here. Mount Sinai. We're almost ready to start a dig over here. So that's really good. Let's see, how are these guys are doing? A few more turns before they're done. Let's see, these guys are finished, so that's good. Let's move them over here and get started on a farm maybe. Another archaeologist has finished. We still haven't done anything with this dig site, so... Yeah, because I've been prioritizing dig sites far away from me, because they could be taken by other civilizations, right? And the one in my territory, they're pretty safe. So let's see if there's anywhere I could send him to. I could send him over here, maybe. And take that away before Egypt gets to it, or Spain gets to it. Hopefully there's not going to be any barbarians there. Maybe I should send along some musketmen with him. Let's select them and make sure they also head over in this direction. Let's see, Timoak has finished. Let's go for... Let's see, stock exchange could be powerful because we already make quite a lot of money here. Let's go for it. Yeah, I need more money coming in than 55 per turn. Alright, these guys have arrived, so they can start digging. Two more turns, then we get the Eiffel Tower. And let's see, we need, after the zoo gets finished, or maybe when Mosankani finishes the Eiffel Tower, we can make another archaeologist and get this antiquity site as well. I think that would be the best thing to do right there. What about these continents over here? There's one over there, that's quite cool. We could take that one eventually. This one maybe, this one. There was one down here, I remember. Close to Sripada. And then... Not sure, oh yeah, there's one over here as well. And another one, and another one. But those are probably going to get taken by Venice, I think. And our worker has finished as well, but let's see, we can have another production set up here. Stock exchange in 9 turns. Or no, let's go for a temple. Get some more faith. And then this guy is finished. Let's move him towards the hilltel and start working on a mine. Let's see. In 5 turns we will have another conference for cultural heritage sites and the banning of whales. I'm not getting any whales, I think. No, I don't care about the whales. So I'm going to put all my voting power into the cultural heritage sites. Yeah, I think with the difficulty settings, like Prince is the one I'm okay at. I could go either way. Like if I have a bad start, I could lose. If I have an okay start, I can win. But if I... oh, wait. Anyway, like I was saying, that was, I think that's because Prince difficulty is the difficulty setting at which the AI does not get any cheating bonuses, right? Because I think on higher difficulties they get a default extra income to culture and money and all of this stuff, so they will be a lot more powerful in that way. But it's not because the AI plays any smarter than they originally do, it's just because they get a flat boost to their income in almost all areas. And that boost becomes bigger with higher and higher difficulties, I think. So yeah, we get more happiness, more culture, and 12 tourism. So that should really help us. Alright, Agadika. Let's just continue on his previous route, I think. So I can either send him to Egypt or Mongolia. That's no real use for them for that. I just want the money. And then not give other people science. Right. We received a knight from Mbanza, Congo. Interesting. Alright, there's a lot of stuff here, so let's go with rough terrain. And, now let's move him onto the hilltel there. Alright, let's go for one more archaeologist. We have another policy ready to go. So we could get +2 science from every specialist. I'm not sure how many specialists we actually have. But, yeah, this would be something that we could consider doing as well. Let's have a look at the tenets, though, the ideological tenets. The rate at which great people are born is increased by 25%. That's really powerful. Covert action could be really powerful as well, but I don't have spies in city-states. one local happiness from Mint, Bank, and Stock Exchange. It will give me some more happiness, but not a whole lot. Nobody else is following freedom ideology quite yet. Plus one local happiness in every national one. Nah, let's go for avant-garde, actually. Yeah. More great people generation. We have enough faith to purchase what are they called? Missionaries. So we should have enough faith for a mission. Yeah, we do, but there's no room for it in this city. Fine. And also, I just remembered we have another trading route available to us, so we could build another or purchase another caravan into Moak and set that on its way in the next turn to get even more money coming in. But everyone is relatively poor. I mean, the last game I played in Civ 5, it was, I could get a lot of money from trading with other civilizations, a lot more than I can now. He wants my gold for a research agreement. How about no? How about we just propose this? Ah, gold, and then this is a much better deal. It's only 30 gold in the long run, but I can deal with that. Like, that's a lot better. Flat and Venice are allies now. That's fine. How are we looking on the World Congress in terms of... Yes, I only have 6 delegates now. Egypt has 9. Right. Another caravan has finished its route. Let's send him to Madrid again for 13 gold. And let's see, broadcast tower. Plus 33% culture in this city. Yeah. It's going to cost us a lot of money, though. Plus 5 food from the hospital could be powerful. Windmill could be good, because we get extra production. Yeah, let's go for the windmill. And let's see, a unit needs orders. Alright, yeah, let's build a mine over there. These guys can fortify. The caravan that we purchased in the last turn can be sent somewhere as well now. So we could send them to Heliopolis. And that will give us 1 extra science per turn. It's not a whole lot. And it will give them +2, but it will give us +10 money. We could alternatively send them towards Bucharest, Brussels. Because we already have trading routes going to both of these civilizations, right? So I don't need that for a tourism boost. Yeah, let's send him to Bucharest. Might as well. All right, next turn. And let's see, how are we doing on time? 78 minutes. Okay, so I think it's about time to close this session as well. Bucharest desires Broadway. I have not started the construction on Broadway quite yet. Kuala Lumpur desires the same. And our defensive pact of Enrico and Gajah Mada have ended. Let's re-establish those. And then, let's see, that was Enrico, then Gajah Mada. Propose, yep. Alright, choose production in Goshutes. A museum, museum, or a stock exchange, because I need more money. Let's go for the stock exchange. Let's focus on doing this. Another unit needs orders. Ah, so this guy has arrived. That's cool. So let's start the dig. And our musketmen have seen some barbarians over here, but I'm not going to engage them. I'm just going to move them. Ah, yeah, okay. So I need to protect these guys from these barbarians. And I think that's all about everything that we can do in this episode. So I will see you guys for the next one.